Okay, first question. How does it feel like to be black in America?
All's my life I has to fight, nigga. All's my life I hard times like yeah, bad trips like yeah.
So, I assume you already know about the recent protests and outrage over George Floyd's death. The focus of this video will not be about George Floyd's death because one, you already know all about it. There's nothing else I have to add to that conversation that hasn't already been said. And two, this movement and the awareness of it is arguably the biggest it's ever been. But at the same time, I feel like a lot of people seem to only think that it's solely about his death. And once they forget about George Floyd's death and move on with their lives, then they forget about the movement and the bigger issues. And I just want to start off by saying that this video will mainly be about the importance of education, because I just personally am not seeing enough people talking about this. So yeah, let's talk about it.
Matt, can you scoot over a little more? Like,
hey.
Damn, this is awkward. We never like talk about race and stuff like that.
We never talk seriously about it.
Yeah, we actually never do.
Now is a good time to do that. I'm just gonna ask you guys a couple questions. Why do you think there are people that argue against Black Lives Matter?
Like All Lives Matter versus Black Lives Matter kind of thing?
I think there is an argument about it because like when you say Black Lives Matter, I think some people get like the wrong interpretation that you're saying that like they matter more than every other race, but we're just trying to mention that they do matter.
It's kind of like a, hey, I'm here.
Yeah, exactly. We feel like the police don't really think our lives matter because like how they treat us like on a daily basis. We're just trying to like bring awareness to like our problem.
The whole All Lives Matter is literally just a counter protest, just to undermine it. It's pretty messed up.
The surge of this movement was a huge wake-up call for me. It pains me to say that it was a wake-up call because this shit has been going on forever, and I'm privileged enough to not have to go through systemic racism. Now don't get me wrong, as a POC I've dealt with a good amount of prejudice before, but obviously not to the degree as the black community faces. And because of that, I didn't fully understand what they went through and what they still go through to this day. So I took it upon myself to self-educate on the history of black oppression in this country.
Are you ever concerned or scared when you're interacting with the police?
We're all kind of taught like how to handle those situations, you know, gotta be super compliant, do this. We all, you know, that's why I can't go out late. My parents know I can handle myself. I'm not dumb, I don't do dumb things. It's just like
I'm gonna have like 10 clips right now just you doing the dumbest things ever.
No, but like actual dumb thing, like she's just worried about my safety because of the police and how I could be treated.
Like how they like handle situations like so aggressively, and like they handle some situations by instinct, which never really seems to work out.
You know, I'm not a bad person, you know, I don't do bad things. It's just the way I look, you know.
So during this past month, I've been looking for movies, documentaries, and books, and just trying to immerse myself in the process of trying to understand how the movement started, why it's still needed. And I watched movies that didn't explain the issues well, and I watched ones that did. But out of all the things I watched, there are two that I want to share with you the most. I'm going to keep my summary short because I want this video to be as short and concise as possible. So 13th is a documentary that explains how slavery never left, it just evolved. It teaches you how the system was created to oppress African Americans from the start, and how they continue to do it in a way that makes it seem unnoticeable and okay. The Hate U Give is a movie that explains what African Americans go through today in the modern age. What I liked about it was that it gives you perspectives from everybody. People who go through it, people who try to understand, people who don't want to understand and never will, and even the perspective of the police. Watching these two films and a bunch of other ones really taught me about issues that I never even thought about before. And in a really entertaining way, actually, so it wasn't like boring or anything like that. And then after watching these films, I decided to go and do my own research on these topics because they just really inspired me to go and do that.
Weren't you like pulled over once?
Yeah.
And then you had the Zoomies thing.
Oh, you want to talk about the Zoomies thing? I forgot how old I was, but it was to the point where I would have to go shopping with my mom for something. Like, I couldn't just go by myself. We were at the Zoomies, right? Zoomies in Pointe Hills Mall. Nah, but then we were there, right? Just shopping, right? You know, usually when I go to the store like that, my mom would just sit down by the shoe place and just, you know, wait, right? You know, I'm young, right? And my mom is clearly right there. This girl, one of the employees there, goes and is following me. I'll be like looking at like the shirt rack or something. She'll like go to the hats and fix it, you know, following me, make sure I'm not doing anything. And she was doing that throughout the whole store, right in front of my mom. And she was just like, And then there was a point to where more people started coming in the store. So she had to avert her attention. Since she averted her attention, she called out another employee and pointed at me just to watch me. And so at that point, my mom went off, right?
She was like, your mama.
My mom went off. My mom went off on the lady. She was like, how dare you, thinking he's gonna steal. I'm really right here watching him. And then she goes to the manager. She was mad and she was just like disappointed too. Like, why, like, that had to happen to me when I was just so young. She's clearly there. I mean, it was embarrassing too, because my mom was like going off on this lady in the store. I'm like, I'm just trying to buy a shirt. I don't know what's going on.
You're trying to buy a Rip and Dip shirt.
I'm just trying to buy some drip, you feel me?
I was just trying to impress Kelly in the 8th grade promotion dance.
We've never went back to that Zoomies. I mean, even though the girl probably doesn't work there anymore, but
it was just hella disrespectful.
Yeah, it was just so, it was just, you know, like, and there was other people in the store too. Other people of all different
races and shit.
Yeah,
they
was
looking at you. Yeah.
Okay, so we went to the same high school and I noticed this a lot, but how did you feel about people treating you differently and making racist jokes at school?
You just kind of get desensitized to it at a certain point. And then my thing is, I don't hate the person just because it's all ignorance. I don't expect you to understand. So many people, for the N-word, for example, so many people say it. This is how they grow up. They don't know any better. What, am I going to go try to fight every single person that said it in the whole school? No, that's not going to happen. It's just...
you line them up one at a time.
Boom! I'm willing to like help people too, or like, I'll say educate
help
them.
Help them understand.
Yeah, help them understand, but a lot of people are just like, whatever. That's really the core of it, just people in general. Because if you know, then you would know better. Unless you're just truly like a messed up person. You know, you purposely know what you're doing, then that's completely different.
But that's the thing though, it's 2020. We have a million resources online to look into these things. We can't justify ignorance anymore. We can't be saying, oh, it's okay, they didn't know any better. Because they should. You know, take it into your own hands or put resources into someone else's.
How we can understand each other's situation about race? Yeah. Okay, this talking about it. Not only talking about it, but listening about it too.
You know, research this and spark conversations about this with those around you, especially with people who don't agree with you. The most uncomfortable conversations are sometimes the most progressive ones.
People already have like set ideas of like race is supposed to be like.
You're saying race cannot be ignored, which I think is true. I know there's like some views out there where it's like, really be equal, we have to look past race. It's not about looking past it, you have to like accept it.
Yeah.
You ever notice how so many people love African-American culture but refuse to learn about or even speak out against the insane amount of issues that they deal with? Why, you know? I'm not trying to prove a point here. I just legitimately don't know why. And there's a bunch of questions that I don't even know the answer to. But I want to get into this and learn and understand all sides and perspectives of this. And that's something this generation has to do to make real change. As corny as it sounds, we have to fully learn and understand the history of this so we can stop repeating it. Because we are.
What would make it better? What would make all the rioting stop?
I don't think it'd ever stop, really.
Never.
I mean, it may not be like this, but it'll stop.
And that's the thing about privilege though, is these issues don't directly affect a majority of people, so they don't even need to care or even think about these issues. But it directly affects the Black community. They are the ones that have to deal with the injustice and pain. In my conversation with Matt and Mikey, it surprised me how well they knew what they were talking about. They were pulling out statistics and recalling specific events. And then it made me realize that it's because they have to know this. They're taught by their parents to be expected to be treated a certain way by racist people, and they teach them procedures on how to deal with these kind of people and a bunch of other things. Unfortunately, this is a part of their life. For those of us who don't have to experience it, we should educate ourselves and be allies to this movement.
Do you think Black people are oppressed in America?
Yeah.
Some people like just get the idea that like, oh, you're in America, so like you still have a chance and like all that. But like low key, like it feels like sometimes like being Black in America is like playing on like hard difficulties.
Yeah.
It feels like you have to do like extra, like get the bare minimum, yeah. Basically.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, we're all in the system, but the system is extra hard for us. I know what I want to say, but I don't know how to get there. It's like when we like as a people try to move up in some way, there's always resistance, or there's always something being taken from us, or something always happening that just pushes us back down. Like for instance, I don't know if, have you heard the term Black Wall Street?
To be honest, I hadn't. So that night, I set aside 4 hours to look into Black Wall Street.
This story isn't one you'll find in most history books.
Bodies dumped in rivers, bodies dumped in mass graves. It was an absolute massacre.
And for decades, people didn't talk about it.
Wow. It was seriously saddening. I never knew this existed, and I definitely was not taught this in school. It really makes you wonder how many other events like this aren't discussed or taught in classrooms.
I think ignorance is the core of this problem. There is an exception with those that understand the circumstances but choose to be racist even though they are informed. But this topic isn't taught thoroughly and carefully enough to begin with, and that's also another issue. I remember learning about the civil rights movement in school, and it was taught like MLK swooped in and saved the day with peaceful protesting. Kind of like they got their civil rights and there was a happily ever after, which we all know isn't true. I don't remember being taught about all the other issues in school. I certainly wasn't taught about events like Black Wall Street in school. Maybe that was just my school, but I'm sure there's many, many others. And that's why people can walk around not advocating or even think about these issues, because they were never taught in the facilities where they're supposed to learn.
I think now is just the time to try to change it. Will it change? I don't know, I hope so.
That's a good question. Do you guys think it'll ever stop? And if you do, do you think it'll stop within our lifetime?
I don't think it will stop. Will it get better?
Yeah, it'll definitely get better.
I feel like it'll get better.
Within our lifetime, at least.
But I think to get better, I think it really has to do with
you, me, everyone else around us, just learning. If there's just one thing I want you to get out of this video, just educate yourself and those around you. There are a bunch of sources for education in the link below.
I don't want to come across as somebody that's like super woke or I'm better than you, because I'm not. I'm just someone that's tired of ignorance in my community, in myself, and I'm learning and I'm trying to learn. And I will carry this information for the rest of my life. And I will be able to act on this information, not just for a week, not just for a month, but the rest of my life. And I think that's what's important.
Southern leaves, southern trees we hung from. Barren souls, heroic songs unsung. Forgive them, Father, they know this knot is undone. Tied with the rope that my grandmother died. Pride of the pilgrims affect lives of millions. In slave days, separating fathers from children. Institution ain't just a building, but a method of having black and brown bodies fill them. We ain't seen as human beings with feelings. Where are you at?